yeah. Oh yeah, it's the end of the world, guys. It's the end of an age. Two scoops of hallelujah, one scoop of praise the Lord. So I got this interesting thought here, and it kind of spiraled off Todd Atkins things, man. And Matt said something cool about the Queen the other day. Matt Pereira, thanks, bro. And so this is not really like a, hey, I've got all the answers and I'm going to tell you everything. This is more of like a, hey, I noticed something and maybe we can study this as a group again. So just a couple light notes. About 70, Israel was in captivity for 7 years, and here we've been under the reign of the Queen. So the Queen, it says here on Google, she was Queen Regnant of 32 sovereign states during her lifetime and 15 at the time of her death. Her reign of 70 years and 214 days is the longest of any British monarch and the longest recorded of any female head of state in history. I think it's really interesting that we have got this 70 connection. 70 years of captivity, but then. So I'm going to just bring up some Bible verses. We're going to talk this out, and maybe we'll have a longer video down the road, like a live stream. Maybe we can chat about this with a group of people. I think this is a really interesting subject. Before I read some of these verses, I'm going to read another verse that doesn't really relate, but it obviously does because it's related to the rapture in a way. So we've got, I always like the Church of Philadelphia. That's the church who's kept from the hour of trial. And I didn't realize this, but I'm going to read this. So Revelation 3, verse 7, and to the angel of the Church of Philadelphia write, these things says, he who is holy, he who is true, he who has the key of David, he who opens and no one shuts, and shuts and no one opens. Well, this is actually referring to, you guys know how I like my twos, this is actually referring to a verse in Isaiah. And which chapter and verse is this particular verse referring to? You probably already know what it is, Isaiah 22, verse 22. And so I'm going to read Isaiah 22, verse 22. Here we are in 2022. The key of the house of David I will lay on his shoulder, so he shall open, and no one shall shut, and he shall shut, and no one shall open. Okay, really interesting. Is he saying 2022? Keep in mind that there are 22 verses in chapter 3 of Revelation. Now, that's not really what I want to talk about. I wanted to start talking about the 70s. So I made a couple notes. And Todd brought this up in his one of his last videos. And Isaiah 23, 15 through 17. Now it shall come to pass in that day that Tyre will be forgotten 70 years, according to the days of one king. So talking about royalty here. A lot of times in these biblical Old Testament books, they refer to kings. He reigned for this long and this, you know, this, that, and the other. And that's how they dated things, based on kings. So here we are. We've been under this queen situation for 70 years. But anyway, in the Bible here, Isaiah 23:15, now it shall come to pass in the day that Tyre will be forgotten 70 years, according to the days of one king. At the end of 70 years, it will happen to Tyre, as in the song of the harlot. Take a harp, go about the city, you forgotten harlot. Make sweet melody, sing many songs, that you may be remembered. And it shall be at the end of 70 years that the Lord will deal with Tyre. Okay, so here we are at the 70 years after the end of the reign of the queen. Is the Lord going to deal with his world now? Interesting connection. I don't know. Let's study this out. She will return to her hire and commit fornication with all the kingdoms of the world, on the face of the earth. Okay, so that's Isaiah 23, 15 through 17. We got a 70 connection. I think that's neat. What? So then it's like, okay, where's some more 70 connections? Now, I'm just going to say, this is not a 70 connection, but Isaiah 26, I'm going to just read 17 through 21. This is a really, feels like the rapture to me. And this kind of connects with the Feast of Trumpet time zone when the sun's going through Virgo right now. And so here we go. So Isaiah 26, 17, a couple chapters after we just read about the 70. As a woman with child is in pain and cries out in her pains when she draws near the time of her delivery, so have we been in your sight, O Lord. We have been with child. We have been in pain. We have, as it were, brought forth wind. We have not accomplished any deliverance in the earth, nor have the inhabitants of the world fallen. Your dead shall live. Together with my dead body they shall rise again. Awake and sing, you who dwell in dust, for your dew is like the dew of the herbs. And the earth shall cast out the dead. Come, my people, enter your chambers and shut your doors behind you. Hide yourself, as it were, for a little moment until the indignation is past. For behold, the Lord comes out of his place. to punish the inhabitants of the earth for their iniquity. The earth will also disclose her blood and will no more cover her slain. So there you go. That's a couple chapters after the big 70 thing with Tyre. All right. So Jeremiah 25. This is another 70 year reference. Let's get it here. Jeremiah 25, 10 through 12, I wanted to read. Okay, so, moreover, I will take from them the voice of mirth and the voice of gladness, the voice of the bridegroom and the voice of the bride, the sound of the milestones and the light of the lamp. Verse 11, and this whole land shall be a desolation and an astonishment, and these nations shall serve the king of Babylon 70 years. Verse 12, then it will come to pass when 70 years are completed that I will punish the king of Babylon and that nation, the land of the Chaldeans, for their iniquity, says the Lord, and I will make it a perpetual desolation. So 70 years of being in captivity, and then I'm going to take care of business at the end of the 70 years. So here we are. What, you know, how significant is this queen? Is there a biblical connection here? It very, very possibly might be. Okay, Jeremiah 30, 5 through 7, I wanted to read. This is not a 70-year thing, but this is a couple chapters after we talked about the 70 years. Oh, I did want to read this too. Okay, let's do this first. Jeremiah 29. Everybody loves Jeremiah 29:11, but read the verse before it. Very significant. Jeremiah 29:10. For thus says the Lord, after 70 years are completed at Babylon, I will visit you and perform my good word toward you and cause you to return to this place. For I know the thoughts that I think toward you, says the Lord, thoughts of peace and not of evil, to give you a future and a hope. The next verse, then you will call upon me and go and pray to me, and I will listen to you. And you will seek me and find me when you search for me with all of your heart. Really nice 70-year thing. A lot of positive sounding things after 70 years of being in captivity. And we've really been captive to this system, haven't we? For 70 years, well, and more, but it's just a clear timeline of 70 right now. So the next chapter, this is a really popular one because some people are like, well, some people are going through tribulation, some people are not. No, well, it's Jacob's trouble, and this is what it says here, Jeremiah 35 through 7. So 35 verse 7, 5 through 7. For thus says the Lord, we have heard a voice of trembling, of fear, and not of peace. Ask now and see whether a man is ever in labor with child. There's that child thing and labor thing again. Sounds like Feast of Trumpets, Virgo. I don't know. I'm just guessing. We're all just guessing here. So why do I see every man with his hands on his loins at like a woman in labor? Aye, Virgo, maybe. I don't know. And all faces turn pale. Alas, for that day is great, so that none is like it. And it is the time of Jacob's trouble. But he shall be saved out of it. All right, so there's that. Okay, and then we've got Daniel. We've got the book of Daniel. Daniel was traveling tonight on a plane. I can see the red taillights. Doo-doo-doo. That would be a good song to redo and make it a rapture song. I can see Jesus coming through the clouds. God, it looks like Jesus. Calling the Christians up to heaven. Oh, man. Okay. Andrew, let's do that. Rewrite those words. Okay. Daniel chapter 9, verse 2. In the first year of his reign, I, Daniel, understood by the books the number of the years specified by the word of the Lord through Jeremiah the prophet that he would accomplish 70 years in the desolations of Jerusalem. So he's talking about the 70 years. Okay, and then we got the 70 weeks in Daniel chapter 9. And we are waiting for the 70th week. And very interesting, that's in Daniel 9:24. 70 weeks are determined. We know the temple destroyed 70 AD, lots of 70s. And then we've got Zechariah 7 verse 5. Say to all the people of the land and to the priests, when you fasted and mourned in the fifth and seventh months during those 70 years, did you really fast for me? Like, I'm checking out your hearts, man. I'm checking out your hearts. So, I don't know. lots of 70 connections. Now, these are just some sidebar things that are not really aggressively connected, but maybe they actually are, so let's just mention them. Matthew 18, verse 22, Jesus said to him, I do not say to you up to seven times, but up to 70 times seven. This is when they're talking about forgiveness. 70 times seven. 70 times seven is 490. 490 prophetic years, you know? Daniel's 70th week. Hello. Woohoo. Okay. So there's that. So he talks about 70 a lot. And then in Luke 10, remember, he sends out the 70, right? After these things, the Lord appointed 70 others also and sent them two by two before his face into every city and place where he himself was about to go. And in Exodus chapter 24, how many elders went up? How many elders went up? You guys already know. 70. I'll just read. Where is it? Well, it's in Exodus 24, but we'll just use verse 9. Then Moses went up, also Aaron, Nadab, and Abihu, and 70 of the elders of Israel. So, hey, 70 is in the Bible. And there's probably some other spots in the Bible where 70 it was. I mean, there is. But I just wanted to just throw something light at you. Just overall, again, the queen reigned for 70 years. We've got this correlation with the captivity of Israel for 70 years. Captivity, but then something happened. Here we are apparently at a Shemini cycle. 2022 seems to be really fitting biblically. And we'll wait and see. Jesus told us to watch. What does that mean? To be aware, to be watching, to be trying. You don't really need to, like I said, you don't need to figure out the rapture date, but if we're doing this kind of thing, we're not going to be caught unaware. We're gonna have a good idea when he's coming. And if he does come today or tomorrow or a week or a month or a year, we're going to be like, yes, I saw it coming. And we won't be caught off guard like a thief in the night. Anyway, hopefully that blesses you. If you want to join the community on Discord, the links are below. There's lots of stuff in the description box. Mugs. Katrina's doing a good job making those mugs and t-shirts and stuff. So, hey, see in the clouds one day closer. Go, Jesus, go. Oh, yeah. Bye. Hallelujah. I'll see you in the rapture. Jesus died for our sins, was buried, and rose again. This user says, hey, was it you who said 22 books have a chapter 22? And it was. Thank you for reminding me. I appreciate that. So let's go here. So there's 22 books in the Bible that have 22 chapters or more. Let's count it together. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, and 22. And obviously the last book of the Bible has 22 chapters. Secondly, there are two books in the Bible that have exactly 22 chapters. So that's 1 Kings. Our King is coming, hopefully in 2022. And Revelation 22. And as you guys know, I've said this many times, Song of Solomon, I think, is written to the bride. It's the 22nd book of the Bible. 117 verses. Psalm 117 divides the Bible. Acts is the 44th book of the Bible, which is the 22nd book of the second cycle, which I think is written to the Trib Saints. And Revelation, the revelation to the Jewish nation, which is the 22nd book of the third cycle. If you were to divide the Bible in three, it would be Song of Solomon, would be Bam, would be for the bride, in my opinion. The Acts would be for the Tribulation Saints. Revelation would be for the Jewish nation. So anyway, that's another little fun thing. A lot of these 22s and 2s are just coming back to memory, and people are reminding me of it, so that's good. And let me just close with one thing. Daniel 2:2:2. Daniel chapter 2, verse 22. He reveals deep and secret things. He knows what is in the darkness, and light dwells with him. And also, just another final note is there's not one book in the Bible that has exactly 23 chapters. Okie dokie. So we've got two that has 22. We've got 22 books that have over 22 chapters. And c'est la vie. Okay, take it easy. Go Jesus, go get tight with Christ. Bye.